So what's going on, guys? It is Jeremy, it's Beatboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you guys click onto any of these videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of these videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So I know I'm a little bit late to the party here, but yesterday afternoon Jamie McDonald was stopped in one round by highly rated Japanese fighter Naoya Inoue over in Japan. Inoue becomes a three-weight world champion after becoming a former light flyweight, super flyweight, and now a current WBA bantamweight champion. It is only the WBA regular title. Ryan Burnett does hold the WBA super title. And Inoue is highly rated right now. He's something like number 10 or number 9 in the pound-for-pound rankings. Correct me if I'm wrong. But, you know what I mean? He's walked through Jamie McDonald. Like, Jamie McDonald, you know what I mean? He's a good fighter. He's a good fighter. At bantamweight, at world level, not the best fighter, but you know what I mean, he was a solid champion. He's been in there with some other top fighters over the year, beat other highly rated Japanese fighter at the time, Tomoki Kamido, a couple of years ago, and Inoue just walked through him, just destroyed him basically, and he hit him with a shot midway through the first round that seemed to rock Jamie McDonald, and then he landed a barrage of shots and put Jamie McDonald down with a body shot. McDonald got back up to his feet, but he looked a bit shocked by the power, Jamie McDonald. I don't think he was expecting this guy to hit as hard as he did. I think he expected this guy to have punching power because, obviously, this guy is being highly rated for his punching power and his stoppage wins at these lower weight classes. But I don't think Jamie McDonald expected anything like this. But this guy is called the Monster for a reason. And then he put it on Jamie McDonald up against the ropes and then dropped Jamie McDonald again, and the referee stepped in and waved it off. So yeah, pretty quick fight, but in my opinion I think it was a little bit early to stop the fight. And I'm not saying the fight wouldn't have ended up with Jamie McDonald back on his back, because I think it would have been. I think Jamie McDonald was about to get ended if he would have got up from that knockdown, or if the referee didn't have stepped in. But I think the referee should have gave him the benefit of the doubt, because he was the champion, you know what I mean, because he was the champion at the end of the day. If that happened in America or in England, people would be complaining about that stoppage, in my opinion. But at the same time, you got to look at it from a safety perspective, because at the end of the day, Naoya Inoue straight away showed that he was levels above Jamie McDonald, and he could have ended up putting a beating on Jamie McDonald. But at the end of the day, as well, like I just said, he was the champion. So sometimes, you know what I mean, you got to give the guy the benefit of the doubt. Or people complain, but not too many people were complaining by this. A lot of people were saying before this fight, Jamie McDonald's way out of his depth. There's no way he's going to beat somebody like Inoue, who was having his first fight at bantamweight, but this guy at light flyweight, flyweight, and super flyweight has just been running through guys, and he just ran through Jamie McDonald. No one's ran through Jamie McDonald like that before in his career. Nobody. Like, Jamie McDonald, he's been dropped a couple of times in his career. He's had a couple of losses early on in his career when he was at domestic level, but at world level, Jamie McDonald has been a solid fighter, and nobody has ran through him like that. But Naoya Inoue looks like he could be a serious fighter in these lower weight classes, and I'll be interested to see how far he can go, and if his punching power travels through higher weight classes, if he can take it up to super bantamweight or something like that. But apparently, after the fight, he says that he signed up for the World Boxing Super Series at bantamweight, because one of the divisions in the next World Boxing Super Series will be bantamweight, and that means now in the World Boxing Super Series at bantamweight, we're going to have four champions. We're going to have Salone Tete, the WBO champion. We're going to have Ryan Burnett, who's the WBA super champion, and we're going to have Inoue, who's the regular WBA champion, and we're going to have Emmanuel Rodriguez, who is the IBF champion. So it's shaping up to be a very interesting tournament. But a lot of people are now saying Inoue is the favourite, even though these guys in the tournament with him at the minute all class fighters, they are world class, they are world champions. There's just no way they'll be able to beat somebody like Inoue, and you could just tell Inoue is a dangerous fighter straight away. You know when you watch this guy fight that, like, he's dangerous. Like, he's so focused, he's just on job. When he walks into that ring, he's on job. You can see it in his eyes that this guy's in there and he's looking to take you out, and that's exactly what he did to Jamie McDonald. But you know what I mean, it is what it is. At the end of the day, Inoue picks up another world title, and it's going to be interesting to see how far he can grow in his career, because right now he's a very well-known name in Japan. A lot of people come out to see him in Japan. A lot of people pay attention to him in Japan. And he had a fight in America, I think, last year, was it? He made his American debut as well. So there are a few eyes on him. There are interest in him, and it's going to be interesting to see how far he can get. Not only in UA. So yeah, comment below in the comment section. It's JM at Sweet Boxing.